last-minute adjustments to their cars to accommodate for the damp conditions out on track ahead of today's practice session. So, Anthony, lots to do, of course, in these sessions, lots of programs to run. What are you looking for when you jump in the car for free practice?
Well, you have basic checks, first of all. You know, is the car working correctly? What are the track conditions like? And you'll be chasing that as the session goes on. Things like that. Then you start getting into the nitty-gritty of it all, and they become more like test sessions, whereas...
Wake up, bitch! It's time for another episode of the F1 2016 Career Mode. Here with you today is your boy, as always, Tucci3-Tears. Going on in today's festivities, we're going to do the entire set of practice, entire qualifying, and bring you the full race, guys. Been slacking on the uploads, so today you get to see it all, baby. Now today, what we're going to do, hopefully bring you guys another victory. We're going to go through, do all the bullshit in the practice session here. We're going to go ahead and do the track acclimatization period. We're going to do the qualifying time, and we're going to do the tire wear test. Unfortunately, though, it is raining, so we'll see how that affects everything right now. As it sets up for that, though, we are going to go ahead and put in, I'm going to show you right now the setup I'm going to use. I'm going to go ahead and put on my dry setup for the race today. First off, we're going to start off with a 6.4 on the wings. Transmission, we're going to be at 80-80. Just for you guys wondering what I am playing with at home, I am using the controller for the PS4. I do not have a steering wheel yet. So we're going to go ahead and adjust the camber. The rear camber, some toe adjustments here. 4.3 suspension. Let's go here. I'm gonna go with the 7. And if you guys are wondering where I am getting these setups from, I use the Codemasters F1 2016 guide. Scroll through there. I try to find someone that also plays on PlayStation 4 and uses the controller as well. A lot of the guys that post their setups with PC and a steering wheel, you're gonna get a big difference in feel here, just because. I mean, PC, you don't know if they're modifying anything, if they're putting anything else itself on there. So we're going to go ahead and use that. This is the, that's my dry setup, guys. So we're going to go ahead, we have that already in now. We're going to go ahead and save. And we're going to do a high downforce setup here. For the wet weather, at least. So let's go ahead. I'm gonna look at the session info here. Overview. What are we looking for weather-wise? It should be dry in about 5 minutes or so. So I'm gonna jump out on the track here. I'm gonna do the acclimatization. To hell with it. I'm gonna do the tire management first. Do the tire management on the intermediates. We'll go ahead and bang this out. Then we'll go ahead and do the acclimatization, and then we'll do the qualifying time. Hopefully by then it dries up, and we switch over to some dry tires. So here we go, guys. Now, the way it works here in F1, when you're on the intro setup, intermediates are for when the track is getting wet, and it's not a complete... wash out. As you can see, the racing line here is kind of dry, so that's where we're going to try to stay in for the majority of this. With the weather being wet, it's going to give me a better time. It's going to, you know, give me a slower delta time. So with that going on, hopefully we could not have to worry about the target lap time so much, but we'll see. It could be just a pain in our ass too, guys, so we're gonna just go ahead, try to bang out these quick 7 laps on these intermediate tires. Hopefully get some purples. And go from there, you know. Just got, right before this race, I got a 300-point sponsor bonus towards research and development. I'm going to do one more upgrade this season, and then I'm going to cease all R&D for the rest of the 2016 season. Wait until 2017 rolls around, see what contract offers I get. Probably gonna stay at Renault, but I'm not gonna lie, at this point, when it comes to games like this, you know, you're always gonna be one of the best. So What I like to use is, be as weird as it sounds, honestly, I like paint jobs. So whatever team I think has the best paint job, I would go to them. Force India, I kind of like their little black and orange scheme. I won't go to Ferrari if Ferrari offers me one. I mean, it's red, no big deal. Ferrari is a beast, me being Italian, everything, I should go that route, but I'm not. I'm going to pass up on it. I don't know if I'm going to go the Red Bull route. From a lot of the people I've followed on YouTube, what they do with their career modes and stuff, seeing how everything progresses R&D-wise, Red Bull actually becomes an animal for... Red Bull actually becomes an animal in season two. They do a bunch of upgrades. They will leap Ferrari and McLaren. Or Mercedes, excuse me. Mercedes, McLaren. And they become just complete animals. They'll be really far ahead of them. They'll be the guys to compete with in season two. If I get an offer from Mercedes, I might go with them just because I like the silver. Maybe Force India, turn them into some animals. But we're having fun in this Renault right now, me and Julian Palmer. Hopefully, from what I've read too and seen in other videos from my other YouTube friends in the community, is season two is when a lot of people have noticed that your teammate will start to steal your setup, and it's also part of a patch update that came out. So you'll notice that they will be running setups as well, and I might step up the difficulty if I win the championship as well this year, or if I could, you know, save up some money and splurge and buy the steering wheel, that could be an option. So when that goes down, what we'll end up doing is going to the harder difficulty. I believe next I have Legend difficulty I can go to, and then after Legend I have Ultimate, which is supposed to be the hardest one of them all. So we'll jump, you know, and we'll bounce back and forth, guys. Try to bring you the best entertainment as possible, best gameplay as possible. And coming soon as well, guys, I know I'm a little bit behind the curve, you're going to be getting some gameplay here for FIFA 2017 as well. I got hooked on FIFA 2016 last year. I played it on the Xbox One. Switched over to the PS4. Got really big into Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, and with Black Ops 3, the pro community switched over to the PlayStation format. Sony took the rights out and they hooked it up for the pros, so I got, you know, I was getting, you know, really into it. I was thinking about maybe trying to do game battles and stuff, trying to find some players to start a team with, maybe even try to go pro, but wasn't 100% positive, you know. And obviously, with that going on, if I want to go pro, you got to go to the PS4. So I just want to go that route, though. You know what I mean? I love gaming. Guys have done it for a while, and it seems like something that would be enticing. I'm not the greatest Call of Duty player in the world, but just the whole thought of just, you know, the game battles, the tournaments, all that stuff, just really entices me. I wouldn't mind trying to do that. Just trying to do something here. Hopefully, try to become one of these big namers that are up and coming in the YouTube community. Who knows? If it doesn't work out, it doesn't work out. We're not going to worry about that. What we're going to worry about right now, guys, is giving you some phenomenal gameplay here of F1 2016 today. Doing pretty good in this tire wear test right now in the rain. I'm glad. Seems like this is a low tire wear track, actually. I got kind of like what's going on here. I'm not going to lie, you guys. You know, just the standard increased downforce setup seems to have me doing some decent speeds here. Thanks, engineer. So what we're gonna do is just go ahead, bang through this, go through the acclimation, and then do the qualifying time. Try to get all 150 resource points. Go into the race, whoop that ass. Try to bring home another victory. Had a little bit of a heartbreak last episode, getting that flat tire at the very end of the race. That was just a kick in the ass. Put a damper on a very good race, I thought I had, in my opinion. But it is what it is. You know, try to do what we can here. Try to bring home a W for not that good gaming. try to put myself into this points lead, try to chase down Nico, and try to win some more money, you know, just try to do something here, try to give you guys something, shit. As always, if you guys like what you're seeing, like, comment, and subscribe down below, whatever you guys want, we'll try to do it for you here. We're not the, oh shit, that was terrible, sorry about that, I don't know what the fuck happened there. You know, just whatever you guys want to see, man. We're here for you guys, honestly. Me, Spanyerd22, we do this just for shits and giggles, you know. We enjoy gaming. It's what we've been doing for a long time. And I'm kind of glad to see the market take off the way it has, you know. There's a lot of us out there that like to do what we do that, for the longest time, kind of got looked down upon for what we like to do. And with what's going on with, you know, Call of Duty's big boom and success and everything in the YouTube gaming community, it's like a big F you to all those people back 10 years ago, even when I was in high school, who looked down on us as if, you know, there was something wrong with us because we like to go do our gaming thing. We got just three more laps to go here on this. As you can see, we don't got a lot of standing water anymore on the track, so that does mean the track is drying out. So let's go ahead and hopefully bang this out. And then I'm going to go ahead and do the qualifying next, try to knock that out of the park. That one's the best one, because if you do better than the purple lap that they set for you, you don't have to do the rest of them. You can just go park it in the pits, hang out. So we'll go ahead and do that. Nice little quick circuit here, minute 11 lap times right there by Rosberg. I'm sitting in fourth right now time-wise, but I'm not really pushing it either, guys. I'm just pretty much on a Sunday drive right here, just trying to save the tires, you know, get into that purple range, get them resource points. Rear end got a little loose there. Doing a good job following this here race line. Now watch when I do the acclimatization stuff, I'll probably end up not being able to hit a damn thing, but we'll see. All right, a little bit of a lock up there. Track's definitely drying out now. That's the only hard part there. Alright, DRS is enabled, so that means the track is now dry. Give it a couple minutes and dry tires will be the option. So we will go to the dry setup that I just showed you guys at the beginning of the video. We'll put on ourselves some soft tires and we're going to go out here and bang out some laps. For my tires this weekend, I went with the softer compound setups. I put in a couple extra super soft rounds. Ooh, I gotta speed it up here. Let's go ahead and put in the rich. See, that's the only hard thing though about this tire acclimation thing here is you're trying to, you know, not be difficult on the tires, but you're also trying to beat the delta time that they give you, which can be a little bit of a pain in the ass. Made the 85 out of 80, so that's 100% here, guys. So now I'm just going to beat the hell out of these tires, give you guys a full flying lap. Let's see where we can compete at with the likes of the guys right there on the inners. And it's pretty difficult here with the controller to try to not do full steering lock, which is what really burns the hell out of these tires. It's a lot easier when you got a wheel. So after this, we'll go buy some time. We got all three practice sessions anyway. If we need to, we can just say to hell with this practice session. Move on to the next one, see if that's wide or dry. So here we go, coming down to the last little bit here on the last lap. Way ahead of the target delta now since we're just murdering these tires, but to hell with them. We don't need them. Track's dry now, so murder these tires. Didn't even go off the track. Piss off. Exceeding track limits in my ass. Around the final curve. A little bit of throttle. Get onto it more and more and more and more and more. And full throttle. DRS and eh. And there we go. That's all we need for now. Return to the garage pronto. Let's go back to the garage. Go ahead and put on our dry setup. .50 out of .50. Suck on that, nerds. So we'll go ahead back out. Let's go to the dry setup that we had loaded. Load car settings. There we go. Session info. Let's go with qualifying pace. Hello, ladies and gents. Set up here. Let's go ahead and put on a sap. Still telling us that. Look at all them super soft, baby. Yeah. Go with those. Let's do this qualifying pace, gents. Let's see if we can bang this one out here. Rich revs for the whole lap. Here we go. Let's see what we can do here. Oh yeah, a lot faster. But that is good to know that if it does get wet out here, we do have a vehicle that can compete. Usually when it rains, the computer's really overpowered. Haul ass in the first one, bury it in. Come out, good run on the gas, early on the DRS, full throttle, stay with the racing line, hug that curve a little bit, barrel in, heavy on the brakes. Didn't think I need to lift there, but we'll see how that hurts my time. Nice little fast course here in Hungary, fast, short, tight. Oh boy, that's going to be a cutting corner there. Fun fact about Formula 1 here. Under full braking, drivers in Formula 1 can be subject to almost 5 Gs of force. It's crazy, considering that fighter pilots sometimes hit up to 8 Gs. That's just incredible toll on your body for these guys, which is how powerful the drum brakes are on these. Time, so. Alright. Well, that's all they wanted out of us, so let's go back to the garage. .50 out of .50 on that, and then let's do the acclimatization test, boys. Burn up these garbage ass medium tires. And away we go. All right, engineer, apex first, speed later. Setup on this car feels real good, real quick. Ooh, we missed that one. About to work on that next lap. Ooh, and maybe missed that one too. Oh boy, get it back on the track, kid. There we go. That's going to be a good zone there if I need to pass cars during the race. It's just going to be an overall quick race. I like this. I like tracks like this. Here, Austria, favorite tracks. Nice little short, quick laps. And then probably tomorrow, guys, I got some stuff going on. I know that later on at night, Spanyerd22 is going to be throwing up another episode of his Let's Play for Final Fantasy VII. Make sure you check that out. I'm sure he'll be on probably around, 10:30 Central Standard Time. Oh, shit. Oh, okay. So I don't even need to beat all that shit. Let's go back to the garage. Do I get all 50 of my points? Well, hot damn, bitches. All right. What are we looking at here? Wow. Lewis Hamilton killed us on mediums. That's not good. All right. So I got to pick up about a tenth of a second here. Okay. Okay. Let's go ahead and end this session here. See what we got going on in session two. Where do we finish after that? A second, huh? Oh, shit. All right. Well, we'll see. We'll see. See what I can pull. No big deal, guys. No big deal. Quick summary of all the resource points I got coming in. Alright, got 1,000 total resource points. Anything in the R&D development area here? Ooh, okay. I'm going to go ahead and... what do I want to do here? We're going to do chassis weight, and we'll do this fuel efficiency. And after that, I believe we will... probably halt for the rest of the season, stockpile them up, get that bonus, and then just bang out a bunch of them. I stay with Renault. So what do we got here for session info? Dry, no big deal. No really need. I'm just going to go straight to qualifying. I already took care of everything else. There's really no need to do this. What do we got here? Tell us.
Hi, how are you? I'm just passing on your qualifying goals for this weekend.
All right, they want me to qualify ninth or higher, finish above Rosberg, which means I got to be like one or two, and beat my teammate, which of course I'm going to do. My teammate's nothing to me. So let's go ahead and look around on the laptop here. Tire update. Yep. All right, now let's go to qualifying, ladies and gents.
We hope you're looking forward to today's qualifying in Hungary as much as we are. We think it's going to be a cracker. This is the kind of track that eats rear tires for breakfast, or so I'm told by more experienced drivers than myself.
Well, tyre management is key here, specifically the rears. It's all too easy to overheat and wear the rear tyres as they're punished out of the low-speed corners. Most teams won't be able to avoid some kind of issue here, especially the teams that are running less downforce.
We don't think you'll have any trouble getting into the next session, so don't push too hard.
Alrighty, here we go. What do we got going on here today? Beautiful weather, dry, cloudy. It's going to drop the track temp a little bit. Alright. Well, race looks like it's going to be dry. Fantastic, ladies and gents. Just nothing but super soft. Fantastic. Let's go ahead and set some hot laps here, boys. Pretty much what that park farm rule is whatever the setup is now, once I start qualifying, I cannot change anything except for the downforce of the wing. So no more, anything that I can't change with the steering wheel or by coming into the pits. Can't change the camber, none of that stuff. So locked in on it. Like I said, I like my setup. It's pretty good. All right, here and away we go, guys. Let's, we'll definitely get into P2 for sure. Maybe even P3 pretty easily. So as long as I can set one good lap here, should be all right. If I could stay around a minute 10, minute 11, should be just fine. Ooh, slid out real bad there. I don't know what that was about. Understeered like a mother lover. Here we go. Got into the grass there as I hit the brakes. Car kind of shot left on me, but you know what? Let's just get all these flaws out on P1 or in Q1. Move on over to Q2. And take care of these guys. Seven tenths of a second behind Daniel. Pick that up there, boy. And the way qualifying does work here in Formula One, first session you just got to finish over 16th. Second session to move on, you got to finish in 10th. And then when you're in third set, qualifying three, wherever you finish is where you finished. So we'll go back into the pits after that. We'll just keep an eye on it once the rest of these guys come through. See how we are in retrospect to everyone else, see if we need to pick it up or not. Let's go ahead and we'll just speed it up a little bit here. Keep an eye on it. Ooh, I'm a second below these guys. I need to pick it up. All right. Well, my teammate, he looks like he might make it to Q3. I didn't look so hot. So, let's go to setup. Pick a new set of tires here. We'll just go ahead and use these. Why not? Get all these extra tires. Let's go on out to this track here. I got to pick up about a second, so let's see what we can do here. Maybe I need the rain to come. I was doing a lot better in the wet. With this overcast, let's try to bang out a good lap here in the dry. So if it does start to come down, the guys that don't come out right away, they'll have to do it on the intermediate tires, and they will definitely be slower than us. So a little cheeky way to sneak into the next round, but let's go ahead and do that. the next race we will have the fuel efficiency upgrade and the weight reduction. And maybe, I don't know, hopefully I don't need to do the power upgrade, but if I do feel like I'm not winning in the straight line game as much as I should, and I feel like we're that far behind, I will end up doing an engine upgrade if need be, just so I can try to stay competitive and try to win this driver's championship. Button with the 126. So that's kind of where I need to beat at least to the next round. Button will probably be right around that 11-12 range in his McLaren Honda. And I know that I got a faster car in a straight line than he does. It's one of the first times I've been outqualified by my teammate too so far in one session, so we can't let that happen here. I'm the first driver, I should hopefully be better, but I do like a little competition from my teammate, so. And speaking of my teammate, there he is. Maybe try to do a little bit of an unfair advantage here since I close in on him. Try to use him to pull me around the rest of this lap. Get on the power, open up DRS, and try to chase him down. There we go. 8 tenths of a second behind Rosberg. Let's go ahead and go back. Still not the best of a time, but let's go ahead and just follow out what's going on. Session info. Where are we at in the timing? All right. Let's go ahead and fast forward a little bit here and just keep an eye on it. If I go low below 10, I will come back out and do another hot lap. So you got the, what we got up here? You got Red Bull, Mercedes, you got the Ferrari, the Williams, other Red Bull, McLaren Honda, myself, and Kvyat in Toro Rosso. So far so good. Got one guy between me and Palmer. Hopefully me and my teammate can make it to the next round. It'd be kind of nice. See how it goes. Vettel's going to come back out and do another lap. He's really the only one that I think could jump us. Which, if that's the case, should still keep us out there. See if he's out on the track. Vettel's who I'm looking for. Alright, well, ooh, now the water is coming down, huh? We got guys out there on their intermediates. So, you got guys trying to make it to the next round on inners. Maybe it does help us out. I don't know. We'll see. If somebody in intermediates can do faster than what we did on super softs, that's pretty bad. But that's really going to be terrible for somebody in a spot like Vettel. If he can't come up there starting back all the way in 12th in that Ferrari, that's going to be a lot of cars for him to overcome. Let's see how we do here. Do we make it? And we just made the cut. Vettel in a Ferrari. That's tough. He's going to have some explaining to do to his owner there. About a second behind. So let's see what we can do in this next round. Session info. What do we got here? Ooh. Wet. All right. What do they want us to take out there? Wets or inners? Ooh, okay, wet tires.
Conditions as they are, I'd suggest you take a set of full wets.
All right. Well, let's go out there, try to bang out a lap. See how we do on the full wets. And then towards the end of qualifying, when it lightens up in the rain, we could come out on inners and try to do a better time on those. This is just going to make everything a lot more interesting. With the dry setup on the car, not happy about that. Low downforce, not really the best for when you're not going that fast. mean, a low downforce like that's made for trying to carry speed through the corners. When it's wet like this, you're going to want more downforce, because that's going to help keep, I got real loose there, it's going to help keep the car going around the corners faster. Give me more control at a lower speed. So let's see how we do here in the full wet situation. And you gotta be careful, because just a little bit of oversteer and you're gonna go all the way around in these full wets. You can try to stick to the racing line, but in just a downpour like this, it really doesn't matter. As you can just see there, I mean, that just terrible of a corner cut. But if they don't want to penalize me for it, I'm going to take it. Absolutely terrible. Gonna have to do a couple more laps here. Coming across the line, force, wow, 1.44, we gotta do better than that, guys. Oh wow, we just don't have the pace here in the wet, so this is a wet race. You could be, well, maybe not, holy shit. This went purple, sector two, out of nowhere. See what we can do around here. How do we do when we cross the line? First place at a 1.47. All right. Fantastic. Fantastic. Let's keep an eye on the session here. Once the rain starts to slow down, it's going to be dry in about 10 minutes. So keep an eye on everything. We had a fast second. And we got, all right, all right, all right. Let's see how we do here. No one's on the track yet. You got one car on the track. Who's out there? Verstappen? He's on inners. Oh boy. The track doesn't look that dry to be on inners, but we'll see who else is out there now. We got Fernando out there. Who else? Bottas. Everyone's going out. Hell with it. So are we. Let's throw on some intermediates and let's get out there.
Intermediate tires.
Take off the tire warmers and away we go. I got 26 seconds. I don't even know if I'll even be able to make it all the way around to start my lap. Really don't matter to me. I'm still in first as of right now, but... I won't even let me finish, so... We finished fourth. Ah, damn. Should have went out there earlier then. Wow. Well, we finished ahead of Rosberg, so that's fine. Julian, wow, that sumbitch. All right, that's gonna be that's a weird lineup there. You got a McLaren Honda second. Teammate Julian Palmer third. I'm fourth. That's fine. You got a Renault second row. I'm okay with that. Now it's time to start you guys with the race for the Hungarian Grand Prix.
I just wanted to pass on the team's expectations for this race. Good luck.
It's always wonderful to come back to the lively Hungaroring, a popular destination this, nice and close to the beautiful city of Budapest, with some exciting racing to boot. Who can forget Michael Schumacher pushing his old teammate Rubens Barrichello up towards the pit wall in 2010, or those great races of 2014 and 2015 as well. Located 12 miles northeast of the Hungarian capital Budapest, the 14 corners of the Hungaroring are steeped in history and prestige. Overtaking has always been difficult on this technical 2.7-mile circuit, but the last few years in particular have turned up some exceptional races. Let's hope we're in for another one here today. With me to enjoy it all is Anthony Davidson, a man who made his Grand Prix debut here with Minardi back in 2002. So, Ant, this is a bit of a special one for you, I'd imagine.
Yeah, I'd say so. I also stood in to commentate on Jensen's win in 2006, and as I was a test driver for Honda at the time, you can imagine that was quite an emotional Grand Prix. It's also a tough circuit on the drivers, this one, too. Lots of long, slow corners that require a lot of patience from inside the car. Plus, it's a very downforce-heavy circuit. I mean, it's all relative, of course, but if you're lacking a bit in downforce, or if you've got a bit of an imbalance in the setup, this is definitely one of the worst places to have to deal with that.
You've done well to put it on pole, but we've still got work to do. Trying to cover the inside line off the start.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position. And it's Fernando Alonso in P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Palmer and a Renault, Nico Rosberg and Raikkonen, Ricciardo, Hamilton, Bottas and Daniel Kvyat, Button, Vettel, Nico Hülkenberg and Massa, Sainz, Perez, Romain Grosjean and Esteban Gutierrez, Wehrlein and Harry Anto, Marcus Ericsson and Felipe Nasser starts from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
All right, as you guys got that summary there, let's go ahead and go over the race strategy for today. We got a two-stop or a three-stop. What do we want to do here? If only I could switch it around and start on the softs. Let's see here. Or can I go super softs into the mediums into the softs to finish the race? See if we can edit that. I don't know how I feel about that. I don't know what to do with here, guys. I'm going to go with this one. We're going to go with the low tire management strategy here. And we'll go throughout the race and see if we get something better, guys. So let's go ahead and let's take care of this. You got five red lights and then away we will go. And away we go to start this Hungarian Grand Prix. Nice little decent start there, getting overtaken. We're going to haul ass in the first turn here. Drafting Alonso, dive bomb everybody. Ooh, went off the track a little bit, but I think I could have had that move there. Jump everybody, a little bit of contact, Raikkonen all over the place, bunch of contact back there in the back. You got carbon fiber flying all over the place. Not gonna go for the pass. We're gonna stay right on Max's butt. Wow, got a little jiggy with it there, got out of control. Go back in the standard red, try to save a little bit of fuel here. Hot on Verstappen's tail. You got Nico Rosberg right behind us. Oh, that's what I get for not paying attention. We're going to go back and replay there. And we'll go ahead and start that over. One mulligan every race. One mulligan, huh? That's what I get for not paying attention. Stay on the track there, bud. Ooh, shit, and I'm going to leave the door wide open for Rosberg. And he takes the opportunity. I got the inside line, but I'll... Ooh, shit, can you stay on the track, kid? Shit. Losing spots all over the place here. All right. Don't worry about that now. You're slower than me. Get out of my way. Palmer's right behind us. Come on, Julian, hold up. Hold that position. Don't give it away to him. Rich Rev's down the back or the front stretch here. Drafting Alonso. We're going to take that position right away from you there, bud. Thanks for coming. Jump right back in line. Heavy on the brakes into turn one here. Easy on the throttle. Let's chase down Nico Rosberg. Got a big old pack of cars here. Not so much separation, which I'm okay with. Safety car, if it comes out, will definitely help us save some of that fuel we need to save here. Oh, we're almost already back on pace of fuel. Hot damn, we're doing some real, we got some real good conservation here. And we got that upgrade coming, shit. Just go ahead and shadow Nico around the track here. Let him pull us around. Onto the brakes real early there. Go back up into the rich revs, try to pick up some of the time we lost by losing the track there, or losing the track line, excuse me. Yeah, I got a feeling I'm probably gonna hit that pit wall. Rich revs in the draft. We set the fastest lap. DRS is now available. Coming in heavy. Don't got no DRS. Rosberg does. Up into the rich revs. Let him draft us around. We're right on his ass. Are we going to be able to make a move? Let's see. A little bit damage to the front wing there. That's my fault. That was a crazy radical move there. Should not have went in for that. Bunch of contact to myself, Verstappen, and Rosberg. See what that damage is. I'm gonna have to change that front wing now on the next pit stop, son of a bitch. We had a little bit of a similar accident like this a couple races ago. Still had the pace, decided not to change it, but towards the very end of the race when I burnt the tires, I just had nothing to offer them. And we got DRS. Go up into the rich revs there. Verstappen just hauling ass. Got a great exit on us. Gonna lose a bunch of time when we gotta switch that front wing, but hopefully with this multiple stop, with a couple undercuts, we'll be on the better rubber. Maybe we might even be able to get lucky and get a safety car. Who knows? Oh, he locks him up. Locks him up going in there. That cost me a lot. That would have been an easy pass. He just locked him up. Couldn't get around him. Got a nice little bottleneck here. First, second, third, fourth. You got those Mercedes of Hamilton and Rosberg just right on our butt. Once I get down to a straightaway here, what's the strategy? I'm going to still stay on the same strategy here. For right now, at least. DRS is engaged. Back on it again. Verstappen, another great exit on us. Don't have it there to make the move. A little bit of contact. Putting a lot of pressure on Maxi V here. We're gonna go for the move here up the inside. And we make the pass. Pushed him out wide, but we made the pass. See what we can do here. We'll see if we get the alternate strategy here. We'll, with us having the lead, I will go ahead and switch over to the softs. Don't worry about that, engineer. I sure as hell won't. Right now you got myself, Verstappen, Hamilton, and Rosberg. Oh, shit. That's why I can't... look, gotta pay attention to what I'm doing there. Looked up at the screen to see where everybody was running. Wasn't paying attention to the corner. Lost everything. That's why these live comms are sometimes a little bit difficult. Post-com would be a lot better. Just don't have a setup for that right now, guys. Burning these super softs up. Can't really stay on the track. Verstappen around us. Hamilton is next. He bails out going into that corner. How are we looking on tire wear here? 62 on the front. We're just murdering these fronts, guys. Max is coming for the undercut. He's already given us the lead. Coming in this lap. Hamilton with the DRS goes by. Who can outbreak who into this first corner here? Leave him a little bit of room. He's still there. He's got DRS, but we somehow were able to hold on to it. We got the inside line through there. In this lap, new set of super softs, new front wing.
We think there's a viable strategy change available to us. Would you like to keep to the current plan or try the new one?
We'll go ahead with that. We'll go on to the softs and then we'll go on to the mediums. And here we go, coming into the pit lane now. And we're in for our first stop of the day. New wing, new set of softs. Hamilton came in behind us. Rosberg took the lead. Ricardo's behind them. Here we go, guys, come on. Getting jumped. There we go, guys. Come on. Put it down. Hopefully we don't get held up. A little bit of a long stop, but it's all right, guys. We'll get it back. Try to keep this wing on the car. Find some of the cars in the back of the field here. Just let them pull me around the track using their draft. They'll give me some DRS, hopefully. Hopefully I don't melt these tires right away trying to get around these guys. Come on, Gutierrez, get out of my way. Go ahead and we'll outbreak him. Pull us down the front straight there, Alonso. See if we pass any of the leaders. Get out of our way, bud. Doing some good old qualifying hot laps right now. Rich revs the whole time. We got some pretty good fuel economy here in this Renault. I was reading online, once you do a full fuel efficiency upgrade, you can pretty much run the entire race in full revs from what I've read. Raikkonen's on the mediums now. He's going to definitely be on the faster compound by the end of the race. Would like to see who that is ahead of him. Take this draft to the DRS down the front strap to set the fastest lap of the race. That's fantastic. Onto the brakes early. And there's Hamilton, so we're right behind the leaders, even with that wing change. That's fantastic. Being held up by the slower cars. That's Pascal Wehrlein. Ricardo just got around him. We're in the thick of the race here again, gentlemen, even with that wing change. So here we go. Just try not to burn these tires up. Dive bomb on Wehrlein, dive bomb two in one corner, that's what I'm talking about. You guys need to watch out for this Renault team, baby. We're coming back. Question is now, where's Rosberg? Because I'm sure he's already ahead of us. Which that's really got to upset Hamilton. Him and Ricardo are battling right now. So we're in the thick of the things here, gentlemen. We're in the thick of the things. Going into the last corner here, we got a caution. Nico's out of the race. What happened to Nico? Let's go back to the instant replay here. That's going to make a big change up in things here for the point standings as well, gentlemen. So this is Lewis. Where's the next one? Here he is right here. So what happened to him? We'll start it off here. You got one of the Williams going to the pits. You have... oh! Engine failure. Nico's engine gives up on the front straightaway. That is crazy, people. Crazy. So he's out of the race with a red, or he's out of the race with the blown engine. There he is. We're overtaking him. And there's a safety car now because he cannot. Come on, son of a bitch, Lewis. That's what I hate, man. The safety cars come out and it's like the computer just stops on the track. Terrible.
Virtual safety car, virtual safety car. Reduce speed immediately and keep a positive delta. Drop your speed or delta is too low or you risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately.
So that's going to just bottleneck everything. This will help us save a bunch of fuel, save the tires.
VSC ending, we're going green, maintaining positive delta until the green flags.
And away we go, green flag racing, boys. That's a really big shakeup for the point. That's going to be a real big shakeup in the Constructor Stamp Championship right now. He did have a big enough gap to where he's not going to lose the race or the lead of the Constructors Championship, but that's definitely going to put us in a great position to gain a lot of points, especially if we can come away with a victory because he's getting 0 points for today's race. Don't talk about that. Well, bring out the rain. I don't really care. We're fast, so. See if we can follow Hamilton. Taking over Ricardo. DRS is enabled. Getting to the draft of Hamilton. Push Ricardo out of our way. Fantastic. Great driving on this half here, the Renault team. We'll go ahead and go back into the standard revs now. No need to be in the rich. Start saving some fuel, even though we're... Man, that's beautiful. We aren't even losing really much fuel when we're doing rich revs, so... That's beautiful to see here. Try to save these tires. This is going to be a long stint on the mediums. How are we looking on the tires, buddy? 24%? We got to get back to it here. Losing some time to Mr. Hamilton there. I'm sure he's going to try to bring it home for Mercedes. Here we go, rich revs down the straightaway. I'm guessing Hamilton's working on Verstappen. Another purple sector one. And that is correct. Hamilton is working on the Red Bull of Verstappen. And with their little battle going on, that's helping me catch up. This is about to be a three-person race for the podium. And Verstappen blows his motor. Wow! That'd have been very scary, right in front of Lewis. Matter of a couple of laps, two of the top runners in this race blow their motor. Hopefully we don't get hopefully we don't fall victim to that. Rich revs, DRS down the front stretch. Go ahead and chase this Mercedes down, and we're definitely getting on them. Heavy on the brakes into turn one. Missed the apex a little bit, come back out, back into the DRS. Let Hamilton pull us down the second zone. Go back into the standard revs as we go into this corner here. And we eat them up, guys, in this first sector. I don't know what it is, but we just take them apart on this first sector. Got a little wide there. Lewis cannot be happy seeing all this in his rear view right now. We still got a long ways to go, so that's why I'm not really pushing it. Just let him get a little bit of gap. Slow in, fast out. Let his draft pull me around the corner or around the track, save some fuel. As we get completely out of control there. Oh man. I don't know what the hell happened there, folks. The car jumped all over the place. Losing absolutely any ground we had on Lewis Hamilton. No idea what the hell happened there. The car just shot left like just a bat out of hell. That opens up the door for Daniel Ricciardo. Rich revs down the front stretch. He's going to be drafting us. Damn it, man. I'm really unhappy with myself right now. Luckily, we're really fast here through the first sector, so I just don't know what the hell happened there. I don't know if I got into the grass a little bit or what, but man, did this car just slingshot left. Luckily, though, that first sector, we just... I don't know what it is, but we just make up so much time. I don't know who that is in front of Hamilton right now, but whoever it is holding him up. And we pretty much made up all that time we just lost. So I'm certain that that Mercedes team is letting him know that we're on the prowl and we're coming in hot on him. And I'm certain that's not what Lewis Hamilton wants to hear. Facing all that pressure the last couple of laps from us. Purple sector two. Can't see the name ahead of him to see who Lewis is battling. But he just cannot. Is that? It's the Mercedes McLaren of Jenson Button. Jenson, you're doing a beautiful job, bud, holding up Lewis. Lewis is going to have DRS, so he's going to probably make the move on this lap. And there he goes. Lewis duffs to the inside. He's got DRS for sure. I'm going to go heavy on the brakes here. They're battling. A little bit of side pod contact. And now Lewis is in the lead. Button's in second. I'm in third. Button's already on the mediums, so I think he might have a reverse strategy of what we're doing. And he swings wide. We get to go by him, and here we go. We are in second place, and we're chasing down Lewis Hamilton for the overall lead of this Grand Prix, which is a fantastic, fantastic rebound after that incident where we lost some of the front wing, came in for our first pit stop, had to switch the front wing out, and here we go now. We are on the soft tires, chasing down Lewis, ladies and gentlemen. This is just going to be a big deal. Question is now, do I try to come in for the mediums one lap early for the undercut, or do I just come in on his time and we just try to pace each other out to the very end of the race? Rear tires definitely feel like they're losing some grip there. Shot out underneath me again. Got a lot loose over there. So we'll see. Here we go into the final corner, coming around the track, going to the Rich Revs. Try to chase down Lewis. As I said, fantastic rebound after that early contact in the race. Losing a bit of the front wing, having to swap it out, and come back and still be in second place to this Grand Prix. Just a phenomenal run out here by us in Mercedes. In the Renault. So here we go, coming back down. We're so much quicker than the computer here. So much faster than Lewis through this first sector. We use that, try to eat up as much time as we can, try to get up on the rear end of him, try to have his draft pull us around this track, let us save up some more fuel towards the very end of the race. Purple again, just killing him through there. Real wide, no big deal though. Bring it back in, bring it around. Wow. Jensen, you did a beautiful job, bud, on your medium tires, holding up Lewis as well too. Slingshot it out wide, got into the grass. Lost just about 2.5 seconds to Lewis, and in a matter of maybe a lap or two, we were able to get right back up behind him because of Jensen. And now we're trying to chase down that silver bullet of Lewis Hamilton, sitting up there in first place. Coming back around, final corner. Ah, that pit wall scares the piss out of me. I got a feeling I'm going to oversteer one time and just hit that sumbitch. 2.3 seconds. Lost 3/10 that lap on him. And here we go. Let's gain some. Try to gain some of that time back here in this first sector. Not going to gain it when I swing wide right that and go into the BBs. Going to lose a bunch of grip on the tires there. Swinging wide, it's not what I wanted to do. Not going to see purple this lap, guys. Just over the halfway marker of this race now. Would love to see how my tire wear is, but can't switch screens in the corners here. Go ahead, drop it down into standard revs. Where are we at? Tires looking pretty worn out. I'm just messing it up now. 65 on the left front. That tire is going away. But at least after this race is all said and done, though, we will win the rivalry with Nico Rosberg. And hopefully we can take over his teammate, win this race, and gain 25 points on him. All right. Come in on this lap. Switch over to the mediums, run those for the rest of the race. And hopefully we could hang on here. How are we looking? 68%. Yeah, I'm going to come in this lap. Don't want to push it. Learned in Austria the hard way. Try to push it just one extra lap so I can have just a little bit fresher super soft towards the end. Blew a tire right as I passed the entrance to the pits. Lost a big, big ass lead. And ended up not winning the race, so. What's the ultimate strategy? What do we got here for us, engineer? We'll go ahead and we'll switch. We'll go to super soft, and then we'll go to mediums. Aye, aye, Captain. Do that. Get about 10 laps in. We'll be on the medium so we can judge it all off of there. Lewis is in. We're in. This is going to be a battle. Shit. Ah, wow. Lost all grip on the car there. Wow. Yeah, these softs were shot. That car, I turned right and the car just kept going straight. Lewis is already in and out before we even pull in. That's crazy. We're going to lose so much time to him. He went to the mediums. He's probably going to finish on those. We're on the super softs. We got one more stop. This could either work out for us or it could hurt us really bad. So we'll see. Lewis just rejoined the race. We're out here next. You got Alonso in between us. Hopefully with these super softs so we can get a big enough cushion of a lead. We'll see. See if this multiple stop strategy works or if it bit us in the ass. So it's too late to go back now, guys. And see if the adding that extra stop hurt us. I'm going to stay in rich. I'm using this whole entire run pretty much as just going to be a bunch of hot laps like I'm qualifying. Melt these tires out. Just try to turn out some of the sickest times we can. Got to get around Alonso, though, because he's going to be holding us up. We're going to go past him in this corner here. Oh, yeah. Try to chase down Hamilton. Try to get a cushion of a lead there. And then chase him down on some fresher mediums. I don't even know if they'll be able to stretch their mediums that long, so we'll see. We'll give it a shot, though. So here we go. Massa's up next. Oh, he's in the pits. Excuse me. Sorry. So we got Hamilton. 3.8 seconds behind Lewis, so let's see what we can do here, guys. Let's see if we can chase him down. Julian's in the pits. See if we could chase down this Hamilton here. He's on the medium, so there we go. I haven't seen purple in a while. 7/10 over fastest lap there. We shouldn't see any rain, but if a storm front does appear, you know. Fantastic. No rain, engineer. That's what I like to hear. Try to turn out as many laps on these as we can. That's what I'm talking about, boys. Killing them. 1.7. Here you are. Lewis, you're right there in front of me, bud. I'm coming for you. I'm coming. If I could pass him and get a big enough lead on him, be able to go back to the mediums, I'll have a lot fresher tires, so we'll see. Don't know if I'm close enough to really draft him yet or not, but almost 2 seconds faster of a fastest lap that lap. Gained almost a second and a half on Lewis Hamilton. Went a little bit hard into that corner there. We'll be fine, guys. Drafting back through here. This nice little long straightaway. Hard into the braking zone there. Just don't hit them. Don't damage your fucking car. We're going to go for the bomb here. We got it. Jump Lewis. He slows down to avoid any kind of contact. And away we go. We got him. Then you got Vettel ahead of us. He's going to be going on to super softs, I believe, because he started all the way back on mediums to begin this race. So he's only on his first stop. He's going to be coming in, I would say, probably in about 4 or 5 laps to put on super softs to the end of the race. So he's going to be one you're going to need to watch out for as well. He's going to be a hell of a contender. But either way, Lewis is going to... Either way, if Lewis doesn't come back in, his tire is going to be really old. So we might lose some positions coming into the pits to put on those mediums to finish the race. But our mediums are going to be a lot fresher than his are. So next step on the lead here is we got to chase down Vettel and whoever's in front of him. Could be one of them Red Bulls, so we'll see. Okay, Ricardo's ahead of him, so. Go down into mix two now for a while. Try to save up some fuel here. We don't got to battle these guys too much, though. Like I said, they still got to come in, so. I just got to get a nice little lead on Lou. And that front wing, we really can't say screwed up our strategy because it didn't. We still pitted when we needed to. It's just how long the pit stop took trying to get that new front wing, so. Ricardo's in the pits. He's going on to his last set of tires, which I'm guessing is going to be soft. Engineer, I really don't care about Alonso. If it's not Hamilton or if it's Vettel, I really don't care. Unless we still have super softs in the bank, I'll come in for another set of super softs. We're definitely the fastest car on the track, that is for certain. We got the draft, we got the DRS, here we go, boys. He's going to pass us, but we got DRS. We're going to go into the rich revs. Make a little bit of contact there. Vettel gets behind us. We hold him off. So we're ultimately ahead of Vettel. He's got one more stop in his strategy. We got one more in ours. Lewis is behind both of us. Hopefully we can just gain a bunch of time. And then be able to chase Lewis down here. 10 laps to go. come by next lap. We'll go ahead and we'll check out how the tires are doing. And then the very end of this race, those new tires, we're just going to burn the shit out of them. Could come in next lap. I'm gonna come in this lap, put on some mediums for the end of the race. It's either going to be a massive undercut on Lewis Hamilton. I don't know what they're going to do, but we're going to come in this lap. We're going to try to stretch it out. These tires are almost cooked. So we're going to go ahead, come in, put on the mediums, beat the hell out of those to the very end of the race, and hopefully we can chase down Lewis Hamilton and win this race. So for those of you guys still watching, stay tuned. You're in for a very exciting ending of this race. I don't care about Grosjean. Guys, here we go. Give me a good pit stop, team. Give me a good pit stop. There goes Vettel. He takes the lead. Next is Hamilton. He goes right by us. Come on in. Put on those mediums. We're still in third. There goes Ricardo. He takes over fourth. Let's see what we can do, guys. See if this extra stop hurt us or helped us. Kimi Raikkonen sitting right behind us. He's hanging out. He's on some softs. He's on the better compound tire. We're in a faster car. We're going to try to bring this shit home to you guys, boys. So stay tuned. You're in for an exciting couple of laps here. You just don't worry about me, engineer. You just keep me informed of everyone ahead of me. So I'm 6 seconds behind Ricardo. Someone's in the pits. That could be Hamilton. Did we come in a lap early? Come in and complete the undercut. Nope, Hamilton's in. That's Vettel. He's coming out with super soft. So he's going to be lightning quick. We passed him up in the pits. Vettel's strategy definitely helped him out from that 12th place starting position. So he's right back there. We're chasing down. We're on the podium. See if we can chase down Daniel Ricciardo. Lewis has a bunch of laps on his mediums. See what we can do here. It appears as if Ricardo has caught up with Hamilton, so they're battling. That's going to slow them down. That's going to wear out their tires, and Big Daddy is coming right behind them to swoop up the positions.
Conditions
I could have stayed out, tried to go back to super softs, but how hard I got to push to catch these guys, I would burn them up. And I may not even have tires for the last couple laps. I might have to nurse at home and just pretty much limp around the track. Can't be doing that, so. Six laps to go. We're 4.6 seconds behind them. We've been really overpowerful in this first sector. So let's see if we can bring that OP. See what we can do here. If Ricardo has only... I'm wondering what kind of stop he did or how his tires are. He must have really good tire management. For him to still be on softs, he must only did a one stop. Mediums to softs, but... I mean, my God, how... I mean, you must have really conserved your mediums to last that long to still be on softs, unless he did a medium soft soft stint, which still, even then, I just don't know. I don't know if I would agree with that there. We did a three stop. It seems like it's working out for us. Well, that's not even them. That's a Haas car. So Lewis is way down there then. Lewis might actually have had the game plan there. With that two-stop. Yellow flag out there on the course. And Vettel's out of the race. What happened to Vettel? Oh, he must have... What did he do? Did he blow his motor? Let's check that out. Vettel with the... That just sucks. Great bounce back by Vettel. Let's check it out here. And yep, his motor just lets go right in front of his teammate. Wow, that is just terrible, terrible luck for him. He was having such a good race. That was crazy. That virtual safety car, the Deltas fucked me up on that. It said I was going too slow, and then all of a sudden I was way over, and that might have been just a little bit of luck Lewis Hamilton needed to keep us spaced out so he could win. But we're going to try our best here. If not, a podium finish still ain't bad. Either way, any kind of points are positive in the Drivers' Championship. With Nico going out early in the race, all we're going to do is gain on him. So, let's see what we can do here, boys. Got four laps to go. See if we can chase him down. That looks like that's Lewis right there, so we're probably not going to catch him. Unless his tires completely go off. Grosjean gets loose. Wow, Grosjean, get out of our way. We're racing for the fucking win, and you're over here playing with us, man. Get out of our way. You're a back burner, and you're sitting there getting in our way, man. Where's the marshals at on that? Blue flag them or something. Get them out of our way. You got in my way. You're lucky you didn't blow out my fucking wing or my tire, man. Terrible. Absolutely terrible by Grosjean right there. Let's 4 seconds, 13 seconds behind Hamilton. So Lewis is probably going to win this. I'm going to try to catch up to Ricciardo. We might be coming into third. Grosjean almost just destroyed a perfect run by us. A near perfect run. That was just so stupid. It's at the very end of the race, and you're going to sit there in our way and block us. Terrible, Grosjean. Terrible play. I'm just wondering how Ricciardo stayed out on them softs. I really don't understand how he stayed out for that long. Those tires have got to be beat. Same with Lewis. I mean, those tires have just got to be beat. Just trying to figure out how the hell Lewis is still just in those. He's got to got really good tire management or something, because those mediums should just be beat. I know I'm pushing mine hard, but he's got a lot of laps on his. I think it's safe to say that Ricciardo's softs are pretty much done, because I'm gaining a lot of time per lap on him. But just want to know if I missed something with Lewis, or was he so far ahead he was able to pit and throw on some softs at the end? I mean, there's just something, I don't know, man. Or maybe that Mercedes, their tire wear is just way better than ours, because I mean, Lewis's been, I don't know, that's just crazy. Trying to figure out what he did differently. I mean, I know I had that extra stop in there, but I just don't know, man. Just don't know. Two laps to go, 2 seconds behind Ricciardo. Go for an engine failure on the other Mercedes right now. That'd be kind of nice. Pushing a little bit too hard now, but definitely catching Hamilton, but here we go, starting the last lap of the race. See what we can do here. The racing is definitely for... We're definitely racing for fucking second right now. You got the slower car ahead of us of... it's one of those Saubers. It's Nazar, so... Could he be a partial factor of this? Could this slower car play a role? He's definitely blocking Ricardo. Slowed him up enough for us to be able to go on the inside. We pick it off. Going to the penultimate corner. Lewis Hamilton comes across to win. Just a phenomenal drive by us, though, guys, to come back, take over second place. Fantastic run there in the Renault, guys. Fantastic run. Fantastic. Second place. Fantastic.
A great win, then, for the Mercedes team today. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
It was a question of right place, right time today. We were looking at an entirely different race before the safety car came out, but they were able to take full advantage after the field had been bunched up.
So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophies. It's yet more silverware to take back to their base in Brackley after another excellent Grand Prix. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. Well, the lead at the top has come down after a poor result for our points leader. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Well, it's got to be Felipe Massa, hasn't it? He fought so hard and had incredible pace at times. I don't think anyone did a better job today.
On to the constructors then. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. After all that excitement, it's time for a lie down, I think. Thanks for joining us, and goodbye until the next race.
Alright guys, as you can see here, we're only just 19 points behind Nico. Him getting that DNF did not help him out at all in this race, but he still got a nice, comfortable lead. Brought back a pretty decent race. Damage early on could have cost it, but we came back. We bounced back, guys. We had a decent run. Getting more resource points. We win the rivalry. Beat our session goal, destroyed our teammate, beat the rivalry, and we're above target. More career score updates. So that's it, guys. Thanks for tuning in. Hopefully you enjoyed watching what you did. Next race we come in, you're going to see here, we're going to have the fuel efficiency. We're going to have the chassis weight reduction. Williams has jumped Ferrari. We're going to be just a step below them. Hopefully we could jump them too, maybe by the end of the season if I do another upgrade. If not, I'm sure by next year we'll be up there. Red Bull's in second. Williams in third. Ferrari fourth. We're in fifth. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Hope you enjoyed the race. As always, like, comment, subscribe. Hope you enjoyed it. We'll see you next time.